I was so hard-headed at first. My grandma didn't even believe in me. I kept going, though. All I can say is I told you. Jury at the bank now in the vault. You should have never doubted me. I'ma work to my last breath. I'ma hustle to my last breath. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, you should have never doubted me. The pain and the struggle followed me. My daddy never not bothered me. And it's called screen.
I have like trying to film a video and I have all these water spots in my vision. So today we started with dumbbell stiff leg deadlift and a dumbbell lunge, a stationary lunge. I've been starting my leg workouts with this lately because I need to warm up, you know, before I get into any type of heavy stuff. Back in the day, I used to just like kind of warm up. Like if I was gonna squat, I'd warm up with squats and just squat. But it takes a little bit longer now. Not that I'm an old man or anything, but kind of old in lifting years. I've been doing it for like a decade, so things just take a little bit longer to get moving. So I don't like to do it with like cardio or something that just kind of burns a lot of energy. I'd rather do it with something that's similar to the movement that I'm gonna do. So we started with that, and I like to use dumbbells instead of a barbell for the stiff leg deadlift because I feel like I can change the angle of my hands. Like if I wanna do like a neutral grip or supinate or pronate or whatever I wanna do, it's more comfortable whenever I'm on the descent and feeling the stretch in my hamstrings. So if I'm using a barbell, I tend to feel a lot more in my lower back and I'm not getting as much work done on the hamstrings and the glutes. So after we did the warm-up, we moved on to leg press, and I like to do these with one leg at a time. So we hit that, we decided to do kind of like a, I would call a strip set, like a modified strip set, in that we pulled one plate off of each side. Now if you're loading it up, if you put all the weights on one side or the other, it doesn't really matter because it's a sled that you're pushing. So you can do this without, you know, saying, oh, you're working one side more than the other because of where the weight's at. So we did that and stripped the weight all the way down to nothing, which is a way of making the light weight that's on there feel heavy and feel hard. So after that, we followed the leg press with a hip-mounted hack squat machine. Now, up until recently, I always hated these machines. I prefer the shoulder mount. I wanted something that was, I could put a lot of weight on there and I could drive through my shoulders, and I just felt like it worked my legs a little better. But once I started using this machine and keeping the weight lighter and focusing on the stretch of my hamstrings and the actual contraction of the muscle, I realized what kind of valuable tool it could be. So we worked up to, I think, three plates here, which isn't very heavy, but with the hack squat, you wanna be careful with it. Like if you go too heavy on a hack squat, it can be knee problems, you can tear stuff, because you're putting a lot of stress on the quads in the front of your leg. So, you know, we started with one plate, worked our way up. We did a couple pauses in there where we'll go halfway down the rep, pause for a couple second count, all the way down to the bottom of the rep, pause, and then come back up. Again, these are just techniques that are used to make a heavyweight, or excuse me, to make a lightweight feel heavy. And that's the whole point, is we wanna train the muscle hard, we wanna train the body hard, but we're not exactly blasting it with heavy weight to try and make the legs explode and grow a lot bigger. Then finishing the workout, we did some leg extensions and leg curls. With the leg extensions, we kind of just decided to do roughly 10 reps and gradually increase the weight as we went. And we would just go, the three of us. So your rest period is while the other two guys are lifting, and then you're up and then they're resting, and you just keep this cycle going. So we're burning that machine down. We're just making it hot with just reps after reps after reps. And we're trying to hit 10 reps and gradually increasing the weight, which means that as you go along, you're gonna become more fatigued and then use a heavier weight, which is, sounds kind of stupid because it sucks, it hurts, but it'll leave your quads with just a gnarly pump. It's one of the best ways to kind of finish them off because you've already hit it with some compound movements. You know, we've hit the leg press and the hack squat and everything else. So we'll just blast the quads with the leg extension and call it a day. We did need to hit some hamstrings, and I am training hamstrings multiple times a week right now, so I wasn't too worried about getting a lot of work done in today. But we did some lying leg curls, and I usually do that or some seated leg curls or some type of another stiff-legged deadlift variation. That's pretty much it. I mean, the hamstrings, they don't get hit with a lot of variety of exercises. They pretty much curl the lower leg and help stabilize the hip in some movements. So, you know, the leg press and the hack squat and stuff we were doing is also working the hamstrings. So there's not a whole lot of direct work that you need to give them. Simple stuff, just do lying leg curls and just do a shitload of reps, and that usually does a pretty good job of building them up.
I'ma kill the competition and I'm playing for keeps. You see water dripping out me damn kitchen.
So I think Kevin and I are out here on this California summer day melting, like literally melting because it's hot as shit outside. So we'll wrap the video up. You guys are, fuck that one all up. Nah, let it roll, we'll just put that in there. You know, this is a live with Brandon Gurdes from Body Geeks outro. Until next time, you're watching Body Geeks.
My dream's all I got and I'll die for it. If I love it with a passion, I'ma ride for it.